Greetings, Grand Risings, Otep, and Islam to all of the listeners present today. I pray that you are all safe and in good health. The aim of this presentation is to share with you the actual patent that the United States has had on COVID-19 for over a decade. So you see here that this is an actual patent that the United States has on the coronavirus. And it has the patent number over to the right. The date of the patent is May 22nd, 2007. And if you look under that section, now you see the coronavirus isolated from humans. And it has 75 inventors, and their names are listed here. This is also showing you it is been patented before, a foreign patent document from October of 2004. Other publications down here I see is early highlighted from the Genbank Ascension number AY278554 SARS coronavirus CUHKWI complete genome, and the version number again April 18th, 2003. So this patent has been around, or the coronavirus has been around since 2003, from the earliest dates that I see here on this actual patent. There's the US patent number, there's the barcode there, US00722-0852-B1. Okay, so I'll ask myself this question, and I want you to ask the same question to yourself. How did this virus first come out in China if the United States owned the patent? That's my question. Things that make you go, Also, you will notice here on the left-hand column where it says number 75, it has a list of the inventors of the coronavirus. Coronavirus isolated from humans, inventors. You notice, like I have noticed, that they're all from the United States. That's pretty interesting. So the inventors of the coronavirus, not the patent, they are all from the United States. So again, it makes you wonder, how did it end up in China first? So as we continue to look at these slides, notice that this is still page one. So if you're following along, or if you're going to go back and look and study this for yourself, please note that this is still on page one. I want you to look over to the left where it says assignee. But above that, notice how the names of the inventors continue. And you see that they're all basically from the United States, Georgia area, okay? Now, the assignee, it says, is the United States of America as represented by the Secretary of the Department of Health and Human Services, Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, Washington, D.C., U.S. I was wondering what the assignee meant, and so I looked it up. The definition of assignee is a person to whom a right or liability is assigned. The legal definition, a person, company, or entity who receives the transfer of property, title, or rights from a lawful contract. So we see that the United States would be a company who received this property from a lawful or in the form of a lawful contract. I find this very interesting. And I find this very interesting because I had been thinking that somehow the United States wouldn't, which would not be difficult to do, may have planted the bug in China, because China had been becoming this mega financial superpower over the United States for some time, and the United States wanted to bring her down. And I believe my last video, I talked about that, and there's a video on YouTube, a documentary actually about, I can't remember the name of it offhand, but I'll think of, and I'll try and put it in the description below for you. Now, in this document to the right, update, you see I highlighted some sections, so it's too long for us to read the whole thing. Update: outbreak of severe acute respiratory syndrome worldwide, 2003. And this was in MMWR Weekly, and you can look that up. Emory et al., real time reverse transcription. Okay. And then it goes on to say polymerase chain reaction assay for SARS-associated coronavirus. Emergency, I'm imagining with the abbreviation, infectious disease. And then it has some numbers and a date, 2004. I actually read this sentence by sentence, line upon line. But I'm not going to make the video too long. I want you to do your own research and look up some of these things for yourself. Now, if you go down a little bit on the left under assignee, you'll see number 22 and a little note sign there. Okay. And it says filed. It was filed April 12th, 2004. So I also looked that up, and it says that the coronavirus was assigned to the United States of America in 2004, prior to Republican President George W. Bush's second term. Okay, so we can kind of have an idea of when it was started, how it got started, and what president was in office at the time. And I don't know, I can't say for a fact that all the presidents from that time till now knew about it, but it most certainly and most likely was created as biological warfare and is being used for that purpose, and perhaps it got out of control. Okay, so we're going to continue down a little further to the right where it says abstract. And this abstract, you'll begin to see it where it says disclosed herein is a newly isolated human coronavirus. Again, on the right side of this screen, on the bottom, it says abstract. Note, disclosed herein is a newly isolated human coronavirus. So you see, a lot of people think that this only came from animals, and so that human beings could not get it. An animal did not create it. It was created also and and was tested on animals. Okay, so we're seeing here that it was a deliberate creation, a newly isolated human creation for humans, for human beings. Are you shocked yet? So, moving right along, we're going to continue to go down a little bit here on slide number 4. And if you look on the top right corner, it's a continuation of the abstract comment. Now, it says that this disclosed herein is a newly isolated human coronavirus. In parentheses, it's called SARS-CoV. Disclosed herein is a newly isolated human coronavirus, or SARS-CoV, the causative agent of severe acute respiratory syndrome. Also provided are the nucleic acid sequence of the SARS-CoV genome and the amino acid sequences of the SARS-CoV open reading frames, as well as methods of using these molecules to detect a SARS-CoV and detect infections therewith. Immune stimulatory compositions are also provided along with methods of their use. Okay, so as well as the methods, it says, of using these molecules to detect SARS coronavirus and detect infections therewith. So they also are disclosing the information of how to detect the coronavirus within human beings. Okay. And also, which I did not highlight the last sentence, immune stimulatory compositions are also provided along with methods of their use. Okay, so this is a little scientific, but you can break it down to in simple layman's terms to understand that it's saying immune is our immune system, stimulatory, okay, to stimulate the immune system. Okay, so immune stimulatory compositions are also provided. So they're going to show you the immune system compositions and the methods of their use here. It's a very, very in-depth report. Here is a black and white picture of what the coronavirus, the cells, or the whatever you want to call them, look like, or the coronavirus cells, okay? Or the coronavirus attached to cells. And this picture has been plastered all over television, internet, newspapers, magazines. I feel as though they want you to get this picture stuck in your mind so that it will cause you to become fearful and have this mental picture in your mind. You see, because whatever mental picture we hold in our mind, especially with emotion, we create for ourselves. Our body is a very complex and yet simplistic unit when it comes to creation. So when we think about a thing over and over again, and we have the visual, but in the pictures, they make it this pretty blue and red color. I stopped looking at it in the first week. When I hear stories now of the coronavirus and I see the picture, I'm asking you to consider doing the same thing. Do not allow them to plant that picture in your head. Something beautiful and the pretty picture. This does not look like a pretty picture. Okay? Don't allow that image to stick with you And do not allow this picture to stick in your mind with your emotion so that it becomes a reality for you. I had the coronavirus. I was afraid of catching the coronavirus. I had it when it first came to Washington. As quiet as it may be known, I was one of the first ones to get it in King County after the nursing homes. So I know that fear can produce a thing for you. Now, when I caught it, I can honestly say I had stopped for a brief moment thinking about it and envisioning and worrying if I would get it because I had some factors. I thought to myself, I have some health issues that may make me, and my age also would make me ripe for the plucking, so to speak. Okay, so do not allow fear. I mean, you rebuke it, put it aside, say affirmations. This is not my truth. Okay, so there are many more pictures in this article and many more graphs or explanations, but you can look those up on your own. I just wanted to show you this picture. It's not beautiful and pretty and colorful like the ones that they're showing you on media in the media. So when you look at it like this ugly, you're going to reject this. It doesn't apply to you. So reject it. Don't allow it to apply to you, and just receive it as information and let it go, as if you never saw it. Moving right along, we have some information down here under Statement of Government Support in the left-hand column. Reads, this invention was made by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, an agency of the United States government. Therefore, the United States government has certain rights to this invention. Field of disclosure. This invention relates to a newly isolated human coronavirus. More particularly, it relates to an isolated coronis or coronavirus genome. Isolated coronavirus proteins and isolated nucleic acid molecules encoding the same. The disclosure further relates to methods of detecting a severe acute respiratory syndrome associated coronavirus and compositions comprising immunogenic coronavirus compounds. Did you get that? You understand it all? Okay, so let's just take a second and break this down a little bit, okay? First of all, it says that this invention was made by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Now, that's an oxymoron, right? The invention was made by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. I don't know. Maybe they should change the name of this agency. I'm just saying. This invention going on relates to a newly isolated human coronavirus. A newly isolated human coronavirus. It's an invention. More particularly, it relates to an isolated coronavirus genome and isolated coronavirus proteins and isolated nucleic acid molecules encoding. The encoding means the information that they're putting, encoding the same. Okay. So it goes on to say that it also relates to methods of detecting a severe acute respiratory syndrome. So that they made it, they create it, and they can detect where it is found in a human being. Okay, so they know all along full well what they're doing. Over to the right, where you see number 10, it says coronavirus infections are generally host specific. With respect to infectivity and clinical symptoms, coronaviruses further exhibit marked tissue tropism. I looked up that word tropism, and it means a tropism from Greek tropos is a biological phenomenon indicating growth or turning of a movement of a biological organism, usually a plant, in the response to an environmental stimulus. Okay, so it says that it's a biological, meaning having to do with biology, having to do with our bodies, bio, okay, indicating growth or a turning of a movement of an organism, a biological organism. And it says in response, so it's responding to an environmental stimuli. So it's responding to a creation. Okay. Us people infected with the coronavirus that was deliberately created, our experience growth and a turning movement, a phenomena that's not naturally occurring. Okay, and in response to an environmental stimulus, something from the environment that's stimulating the growth or the behavior of this virus inside of human beings. And we're learning well what that is. Going right along, it says, coronaviruses further exhibit marked tissue tropism. Infection in the correct host species or tissue type may result in an abortive infection. Mutant virus protection and altered virulence. Okay, so coronaviruses generally do not grow well in cell cultures and animal models. For human coronaviruses, infection are lacking. Therefore, little is known about them. Okay, so little is known about something because it never existed before. It says they don't generally grow well in a culture, like, little petri dishes in science class you did when you were in the, I don't know, fifth, sixth grade, seventh, eighth grade. And it goes on to say in line 15, and animal models for human coronavirus infection are lacking. Huh? Animal models for human coronavirus infections are lacking because they don't exist. Therefore, little is known about them. How can you know something about something that we didn't catch the coronavirus from animal model? We caught the coronavirus because it was made for human beings, you and me, as a biological warfare. So it goes on to say the known human coronaviruses are notably fastidious in cell cultures, preferring select cell lines, organ culture, or suckling mice for propagation. So, how I understand this is saying is that it's most likely they created it from suckling mice, young mice who were still nursing or suckling. Suckling means breastfeeding. The babies are breastfeeding. Okay. Moving right along, I'm trying to speed this up for you a little bit here. So now we're going to move right along. Moving right along to the left-hand column on the next slide, slide number 7, the coronaviruses are a diverse group of large enveloped positive stranded RNA viruses that cause respiratory and enteric diseases in humans and other animals at approximately 30,000 nucleotides, your genome is the largest found in any of the RNA viruses. Coronaviruses are spherically 100 to 106 nanometers nm in diameter, with 20 to through 40 nm complex club-shaped surface projections surrounding the periphery. Coronavirus share common structural proteins, including a spike protein, membrane protein, envelope protein, and in the subset of coronaviruses, a hemagglutinin interace protein, S protein. Let me stop here for a minute. Now let's go back above. Let me break this down a little bit here. Okay, this is the coronaviruses, and I skipped the parentheses part. Okay, now meaning a family of coronaviruses are a diverse group of large and envelope positive stranded RNA virus that cause respiratory and enteric diseases. Now, the numbers here is what I want to point out. At approximately 30,000 nucleotides, NT, their genome is the largest found in any of the RNA viruses. Okay, now they're either doing this deliberately, saying, hey, let's really make this thing as powerful as we can, because we want it to be as productive as it can be, as powerful. Okay, this really, it was a blow in my mind. It's like 30,000 nucleotides. At approximately 30,000 nucleotides, their genome is the largest found in any of the RNA viruses. Coronaviruses are spherically 100 to, now saying that they're normally spherically or shaped, or the size of their shape is normally 100 to 160 nm. I'm saying nanometers because that's the only thing that comes to my mind. Now, if I'm wrong, please forgive me, okay? But if you look at it from this now, let's just say you had $100 to $160, you might be able to work with that for about a week or two if you're living modestly. But if you had $30,000, we're moving into a year, 2 years if you're living modestly on $30,000, paying rent, buying groceries, etc. Right? Okay, so you can see the difference in that analogy. Okay. I don't know about you, but this is just really blowing my mind here. Okay. So going right along down to the next highlighted section. This is the S protein, a glycoprotein which protrudes from the virus membrane, is involved in host cell receptor binding and is a target for neutralizing antibodies. Okay, again, it's a target for neutralizing antibodies. Antibodies are a part of the body's defense or immune system. Okay, your immune system attacks disease, okay, and it destroys those free radicals that cause disease in your body. Antigens are the particles that cause the body to create the antibody. So antigens and antigens, antibody. Okay, antigens are the particles that cause the body to create an antibody. So you see the word comes from the same thing, antigens, antibody. Tests to detect antibodies and antigens help to identify certain infections and some other medical conditions. Okay, so this, it's important when you're reading not to go past any word that you do not understand. Okay, so for these 10 pages or 11 pages that I'm going to share with you today, we have two more to go. I'm doing my best to look up the words that I had some type of curiosity about if I was understanding it correctly so that I can understand it fully as possible, and so that I can translate my understanding to you as clearly as possible because I feel as though this is very important. I really do. And I'm sure that you will too. And I can't wait to get your feedback from what you understand and what your understanding and what you're knowing is causing you to feel knowing this information. Okay. So the S protein would most likely be those things that we see standing up off the cell, in the picture that says it protrudes from the virus membrane. Okay. So it says it's involved in host cell receptor binding and is a target for neutralizing antibodies. So the things that protrude from the cell that come from what look like a stem, and the top would be reminiscent of a flower or a bud. Okay, so it is responsible for neutralizing the antibodies which are meant to protect us. Those are the receptors. Okay. Moving right along. Down to the next highlighted part, the coronavirus genome consists of two open reading frames, yielding an RNA polymerase and nested set, etc., etc. The genus coronavirus includes at least 13 species, which have been subdivided into at least three groups. Okay, so I've heard people say there's different species of the coronavirus, and here we have the proof, which have been subdivided into at least three groups, group one, two, and three, on the basis of serological and genetical properties. Okay. So that is interesting to know that there is 13 different species. That's my point of this section. So I didn't look up the word serological, which is obvious I'm not clear on. If you want to do that and leave a comment under the video, please do. Over to the right-hand column where you see the number 35, we'll continue. It says coronaviruses have not previously been known to cause severe diseases in humans, but have been identified as a major cause of upper respiratory tract illnesses, including the common cold. Repeat infections in humans are common within and across stereotype, suggesting that immune response to coronavirus infections in humans is either incomplete or short-lived. Okay, again, I would say repeat infections in humans are common within and across stereotypes, suggesting that immune responses to coronavirus infections in humans is either incomplete or short-lived. So, meaning if you get it again, and I'm glad I'm reading this again because I understand it better now. I was asking my doctor if I could catch it again. Now, I was hospitalized for 6 days. I was sick for a total of 6 weeks. Okay, I was sick for about 10 days before I went in the hospital. And when I went in the hospital, they said I had my left lung was infected. The next morning, they tested me for COVID and I came back positive. As I was in the hospital, a couple of days went by. I became infected in both of my lungs. I was having a really difficult time breathing. And now I know why, because these RNA strands are 3,000 or 30,000 times the size of a normal genome. And of course, that is going to have a severe reaction and kill a lot of people instantly. Now, here, I'm happy, and I hope you can hear this. It's saying that if you're infected again, okay, that it's not likely that, I mean, that it is likely that the coronavirus infection in humans is either incomplete or short-lived. And I want to make that point because since I've been home, I felt like that I may have had it at least two times for sure. You know, and I didn't want to go back and get tested because I was afraid. Fortunately, we have a hot tub. I got in the hot tub and I felt better almost instantly. Now, the other day, I don't know, I had indigestion or something. I think that I've become paranoid about it now, reasonably so. I had a friend who saw my video on Facebook. I have my whole maybe about six videos I recorded while I was in the hospital. And she said when she saw my first video, she said to herself, "Oh boy, she's on her way out of here." And I told her, "What? I was feeling a lot better then. You know, I lost 16 pounds and you know, in a couple of weeks I wasn't eating. I hadn't eaten for 4 days when I went into the hospital, and then they wanted me to eat, so I just ate picked on blueberries for a couple of days, and slowly my appetite came back, and yay me, I've gained half of those pounds back. I wish I can get rid of them, but not like this." Okay, so I'm almost done here, and there's just a couple more sections in the pages below. So this is important to know, and you can share this with other people. My doctor told me that she heard of someone in an article she read that may have caught it again. So if I was to have had myself tested at that time, then I may have said that I was in positive for the coronavirus again. Okay, so now it says, and you can read this part over again. Okay, vaccination has been used successfully to prevent and control some coronaviruses infected in animals. The ability of animal-specific coronaviruses to cause severe disease raises the possibility that coronaviruses could also cause more severe disease in humans. And like I said, especially with the massive size of the genome that was created in this coronavirus for human beings. This is deliberate, people. And yes, I have some ideas of what we can do about that. People who have actually had it. Everybody's been infected by it, affected by it, I'm sorry. Line 50. In late 2002, cases of life-threatening respiratory disease with no identifiable etiology were reported from Guangdong Province, China, followed by reports from Vietnam, Canada, and Hong Kong of severe febrile respiratory illnesses that spread to household members and healthcare workers. The syndrome was designated severe acute respiratory syndrome, or SARS, in February 2003 by the Centers of Disease Control and Prevention. Okay, so we see that's where I see in this report the first mention of China, and this is not calling it the coronavirus, this is calling it SARS. Okay, so we see the majority of the information here is pointing to the United States. I'm rethinking my comment on number 35 over here on whether or not the repeat infections are possible in humans. So I'm thinking of seeing coronavirus infections here. Repeat infections in humans are common, okay, and a cross stereotype suggesting that immune responses to coronavirus are short-lived. So meaning that the immune response, which would keep us from getting it, are short-lived. Okay. So, or either incomplete. So it would make it possible for a person who was infected to be reinfected. In my earlier comment, I looked at it in the reverse, which meant I was thinking that it was saying that if we did come into contact with it again, repeat infections are common, right? Suggesting that immune responses to the infection in humans is either incomplete or short-lived. So the responses or the immune response and the antibodies that would normally fight off this coronavirus is short-lived. And so I'm thinking that it's possible that in this sentence is saying to me now and to us is that it is possible. So be careful. Moving right along. If you look over now to the bottom of page 9, on the left-hand column, it reads, the three known groups of coronaviruses are associated with a variety of diseases of human and domestic animals. For example, cattle, pigs, cats, dogs, rodents, and birds, including gastroenteritis and upper and lower respiratory tract diseases. Known coronaviruses include human coronavirus 229E, in parentheses, along canine coronaviruses, CCoV, feline infectious peritonitis virus, porcupine transmissible gastroenteritis virus, gastroenteritis virus, porcelain epidemic diarrhea virus, that too, yep, human coronavirus. Okay, so this is something that you can go back and read for yourself here. Again, it's on page 9. Human coronavirus and bovine coronavirus, porcine. It goes on to say rat virus, coronavirus, mouse, hepatitis virus, coronavirus, turkey coronavirus, avian infectious bronchitis. Okay, and it's not clear whether or not these animal viruses, it's not clear to me in this moment if those were also invented. And again, it says that they are host specific with respect to the host. So a turkey can't get the coronavirus that was intended for the rat. The human can't get the one intended for the bird or created for the bird, okay? So moving right along, I believe that this is going to be the last slide. Okay, so I didn't finish. Okay, so the three known groups, it goes on to name all these animals, and you can't see it on this page here. You have to either go to the slide above or download it and read it for yourself. But I did name the rest of the animals or rodents. Past efforts to develop rapid diagnostics and vaccines for coronavirus infection in humans have been hampered by a lack of appropriate research models and the moderate course of disease in human. Therefore, a need for rapid diagnostic test and vaccine exists, especially now with the coronavirus. This is a new strand, and there are a lot of testing companies out there now trying to come up with these vaccines. I myself got better when they gave me the hydroxychloroquine, which I am writing a blog about that, and I hope that they do not stop using it. But it's not a vaccine, it's something that helps you get better, like an antibiotic, okay? I had it along with the antibiotic. Okay, so hydroxychloroquine, Q-U-I-N, actually, antibiotic that I was given, helped me start feeling better by the next day. Prior to that, I felt like I had lost 50% of my life force, and I was on my way out, and I didn't have the strength to even care. I mean, I couldn't emote. I just had nothing to, no energy to do it with. And I know in the spiritual realm that if I had gone, I can look back and say, oh boy, that happened, and be remorseful about it. And now I'm just grateful. I'm so grateful. I know a lot of people didn't make it. And I know that I was asking and praying, why is this happening to me now? So early, I couldn't believe that it happened to me. Like, do I have a kick me sign on my back? You know what I mean? Like when you're in school and they put the stupid sign on your back. I often felt like I had one in life, but not recently. I mean, really. So I'm grateful. I became grateful, I should say, over time, because I didn't have to worry about getting it as much as everyone else. And so I can experience a little bit more freedom. You know, if you haven't gotten it already, don't assume that you won't get it. And they also, or reports, when I say they, I mean things that I've read or heard on television or videos, say that the longer it's around, the weaker it gets. There's maybe millions of people that get it, and maybe 0.5% that actually die from it. In some areas, even lower. So it's not an automatic death sentence. You can do things. I was already, before I went to the hospital, I was taking what I keep at home, oil of oregano, which is a natural antibiotic, antiviral, antibacterial, and antifungal. I always take that when I feel something in me. I was taking vitamin C, and recently I've heard a doctor say you can take selenium. Now, selenium actually remove, gives you free radicals that fight off disease, or free radicals are what fight off disease. Okay, so those things are, I would recommend that you keep in your house. And if you feel any symptoms, it's also said that it can't live above 70 degrees. Get in a hot bath as hot as you can stand it. Stay in there for 10 minutes every day for 3 days. And I'm pretty sure that would be beneficial. If you wait too long to start these things, you might not have the same outcome as I have or others have. For whatever reason, some people are exposed to it and never catch it. Like my consort. He was exposed to it, slept right by me every night, and he never caught it. So he had a very strong immune system, okay? So now we're going to move on to the last slide. Before we go on to the last slide, it says a summary of the disclosure. A newly isolated human coronavirus has been identified as the causative agent of SARS and is termed SARS-CoV. The nucleic acid sequence of the SARS-CoV genome and the amino acid sequences of SARS-CoV open reading frames are provided herein. Okay, so it says in the highlighted area, and I guess I'm not going to scroll down and I have to change the page. So it says that methods and compositions useful in detecting the presence of SARS nucleic acid in a sample or diagnosing of SARS infection in a. Let's go down to the next page. So, yay me, I actually have this slide with the same verbiage on the end of the last page. This disclosure provides methods and compositions useful in detecting the presence of SARS-CoV nucleic acid in a sample and/or diagnosing a SARS-CoV infection in a subject. Also provided are methods and compositions useful in detecting the presence of SARS-CoV antigen and antibody in a sample and/or diagnosing a SARS-CoV infection in a subject. The foregoing and other features and advantages will become more apparent from the following detailed description of several embodiments which proceeds with reference to the accompanying figures. Okay, so I'm not going to go on. This is, like I said, an education for you to know and to understand how the coronavirus came about, where its genesis is or was, and the impact that that had on us. More specifically, meaning the 30,000 size, 30,000 ratio to 106, I want to say genomes that they actually used to create this massive cell or receptor, cell receptor that would cause us to have such a severe and serious reaction and cause such a widespread I'm almost at a loss of words here, okay? Because as I said, I was directly impacted. I had it, and it took away 6 weeks of my life. As a matter of fact, I'm 6 weeks behind on a lot of my work. So I'm a little behind on making videos and being as present as I normally am or was. And will be again shortly on Facebook and YouTube, etc. So thank you for stopping by. I'm going to take some time over the next couple of weeks to finish reading this document for my own sake. I may or may not make a second part. I'm hoping that it says something about treatment, but I don't know that it will because it already said earlier that that there is no history or records of these are my words or my recounting of what I just read because there's no studies because it was just created for humans and now it's finally being put out. And now I want to ask you to try and use your own imagination with the knowledge and things that you may know and things that you may have heard from some conspiracy theorist like myself, who may have read for it and believe in conspiracy theories, biological warfare, that these things are honestly true. Now, I know a lot of people who are listening to this may not be Moors. And it's not, every video I make is not just for Moors, meaning people of color, people with brown skin. It's for everybody. Even as a video about Moors, you need to know and you need to understand. The Moors have made such a profound impact on society over the last few years, and even more specifically now. Okay, now you need to really understand what is happening here. is that the Moors are waking up and they are taking control back of our, we are taking control back of our land. I'm saying they because there's still paperwork I need to do for my own self and family. Now, I am behind a little bit, but I want you to know that they have made no effort to hide these facts. If you go on the Moorish American Consulate.org, there used to be a video right there on the top that talked about how the Moors have put a uniform commercial code lien basically on the whole country. Okay, so now this is because we realize that this is our land, that we are Aboriginal and Indigenous everywhere, and that we have been lied to, right? And that our inheritance ha and our history has been stolen. Okay, not only people of color have been impacted by the deceivers who run these countries, you know, from England to France, all over, they have all come under the umbrella of this conglomerate beast. And it is referred to a beast in scripture. What else could it be? The most scariest thing a child dreams of is a beast. To me, a beast is a bear. I'm not going out in the woods like on these TV shows where people go and they spend like a month in some deserted island. I can't do that. Okay, because I don't want to see no beast. Some people don't even like insects. You know, that might be a beast to you. More than one fly at a time. Oh my goodness. Now, let's just really consider the fact that the Moors have gone. I'm just going to invite you to go on the Moors American Consulate.org and look under the grid. Look under everything that we have been doing and are planning to do to take back our rightful place, our inheritance. We are the heirs. Now, I just want to propose a scenario to you for a minute. And now, have you ever known anybody, or maybe you yourself, you don't have to admit it, was getting evicted from an apartment? Now, when I was in my early 20s, I was with this person, and I had gotten evicted from an apartment, and I had to move. And this person who I was with was so upset with the landlord because I was not treated properly, that they began to deliberately mess up the house, you know, stop up the toilet, put oil in the furnace. And I was horrified because technically it was my responsibility. The apartment was in my name. So I did call them and tell them about the oil in the furnace because I didn't want anybody to die. Okay, so this is my thinking. That they're saying, okay, you want your country back? Here it is, take it. Yeah, but when you get it, it's gonna be a pile of shit, you know? Yeah, okay, you want your country back? We're not going out without a fight. And if this is really ringing any bell of truth in your mind, you will start to understand why our people are getting shot and killed. Out of anger. Now, if you do any studying, please look up the straw man and know that we all have been lied to and that we have all been enslaved in this corporations and through the United States. If you're a United States citizen listening to this, that you have become a slave of the corporation to pay back the so-called debt that is owed to the Federal Reserve Bank. Okay. Now, the United States, in all capital letters, is a corporation. The United States of America is the original, authentic, and only country, the United States, with small letters. Maybe you'll see it with a first capital letter. So when you hear people refer to the United States of America as the corporation, that's wrong. The United States Corporation, everything that has to do with the fake United States, is all capital letters. Even the mail that you get with your bills on it, look at them. They're in all capital letters. Okay? So we are saying we understand what is happening here. And I'm not digressing. You may think I am, but I'm trying to explain to you why the mayhem is going on that is going on. It's because we're taking back what's belonged to us, and not only us, but other people from other races I know are going back to their countries, doing the UCC, claiming their nationality. All this stuff is happening now, and these are steps that everyone is going to have to take soon if they want to come out of her. And this is how I started studying the Bible. I started studying the Bible again. I stopped for a while, and I started reading Revelation again, which I love to study Revelation. And it said, "Come out of Babylon, that you do not receive of her plagues." Okay, so I started praying. Now, why is the Bible telling me, or Scripture telling me, to come out of Babylon? Then I realized that it was something that I had to do. God's not going to push me. Allah, Yahuwah, is not going to push me out of Babylon. He told me to come out. And so I began to seek what for answers of what that really meant for me. And so what that really meant for us all is to come out of Babylon. You've heard Babylon songs, reggae music, all my life I've heard it. And I even wrote one myself, and you might have heard it before. But this is just a picture of the ugliness of the beast that is going down, but it's not going down without a fight. It's going down, but it's going down angry. Even the scripture says that the dragon was wroth with the woman and went to make war with the remnant of her seed. And we know that the woman that Satan is wrath or angry with is the true children of it, people of Yah, Yahuwah, Allah. Okay, now these are all biblical stories that have their genesis and their basis from Egypt. Okay, now you can go back and the names have changed, and maybe some of the location names have changed, but you can see the similarities in the stories. Now, one doesn't necessarily invalidate the other. If anything, it affirms for me that the story is true, with names and changed a little bit. But this is the reality of where we are in time. Real life, biblical history. There, you can't get away from it. You can't separate the two, or else you'll never have a full understanding of what is really going on. Okay, so I'm going to continue to talk to you. Right now, I got to catch up on my own paperwork, my Moorish American paperwork that I haven't completed yet, and that's really heavy on my mind. So I wanted to finish some things today, and this is one of them for you. If you have any questions, or if I forget to post the link to this, I'm also going to post on my website of the blog with the videos of my COVID experiences, my ex blog that I'm writing to talk about hydrochloroquine and how it helped me in my journey to wellness, and what it was like having the virus, and some things that you can do to maybe that might be preventative. And that may have helped me, along with, of course, the prayer of many of my friends and families and loved ones. I know I'm so grateful to have this opportunity to speak to you, to have the knowledge of this information, and to be able to share it with you. So I'll leave you with that for tonight. If I find anything else important in here, or if you do, please share it with us and let the world know. There's so much more to know, and there's so much more to do. And yeah, times are changing, and they're changing quickly, and they're going to get worse before they get better. I hate to tell you. And not just with COVID, but with other things. So let's buckle up, and put on your Ephesians chapter 6. Put on your whole armor that you can stand in these times. Peace and bliss. Check out my website, and if you need any more information or any help understanding this Moorish nationality information, MoorishAmericanConsulate.org. You can look for some videos and ask some people. Now, don't be discouraged, because there's a lot of different opinions. Now, this all the Moors that are coming together are maybe of a different mindset, or have different methods of doing things, but you have to look at the intention, okay? It's the same thing, like if you have a Protestant, there's a lot of different Protestant religions. There are some people that are sane, there are some people that are not so sane in those religions. There are people that are well versed, and there are people that are not well versed. And there are people that make the whole religion, never mind religion, but even your whole family, there's always one or two that make the whole family look bad, right? So come with a sound mind, come with a prayerful mind, and set aside time to understand carefully in your spiritual mindset, in that place where you go, where you can leave the outside world outside, center yourself within your spirit and in your mind in a meditative state, and really study and pray for guidance and wisdom. There are things that we can do to come out of the bondage. There will be some sacrificial lambs. There will be some deaths. But there's a rebirth around the corner. And it's happening now. We are living in exciting times. We are living in what seems to be uncomprehensible times. I'm praying for protection for you all. I'm praying for wisdom and guidance for you all. I'm praying that the Most High will bless us and forgive us for all of our sins and our wrongs. And I'm praying that you will ask for forgiveness, because scripture says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, and I will forgive their sins and I will heal their lands. Yes. Yes.